Let's take a look at the headlines. Once again, the Trump administration is on the offensive, pushing back on the Democrats who are investigating the president. Now, the White House is saying that Democrats are refusing to abide by, quote, rules and norms. Now, here's the thing. I'm not from this country, okay? I've lived here like 4 years. So help me out a little bit. Is trying to fire the special counsel while you're being investigated by the special counsel, is that more of a rule or is it more of a norm? Democrats aren't following rules and norms. Donald Trump is the president of the United States. I feel like rules and norms went out the window about two porn stars ago. Rules and norms. Meanwhile, President Trump continues to dig in on his tax returns, saying that voters in 2016 did not care that he was the first presidential candidate in decades to not release his tax returns. Now, that was quick. I thought the White House was all about rules and norms. You've got to pick a side. Trump claimed that voters in 2016 didn't care about his tax returns. Now, to be fair, voters in 2016 made a lot of mistakes. But it's an inspiring message to voters, isn't it? This will look great on a yard sign. Trump 2020, because you don't care. Moving on, this is an interesting story. A man in Wisconsin went to the police department to claim a backpack that he had left in a library. But the man was immediately arrested because that backpack was filled with meth. Now, I know it sounds stupid to go to the police station to pick up your meth, right? In the man's defense, he was on a lot of meth. He had a backpack full of drugs. So going to the police station, it may seem like a horrible decision, but it also seems like maybe this wasn't the man's first horrible decision. This is true. The backpack also contained a pair of nunchucks. Now, nunchucks, I don't know if you know this, is the perfect pairing for meth. You know, red wine goes with steak, white wine goes with fish. Meth pairs perfectly with nunchucks. And we wanted to show you this. A South Carolina woman recently had an unannounced visitor ring her front doorbell, and you should see who was there. Look at this. It's an alligator. And this is true. That alligator rings the doorbell. I mean, can you imagine someone showing up at your door without texting first? That's just rude in my book. The poor woman in the house was a little confused. She kept trying to give the alligator Halloween candy. Oh, what a costume! I love it! What? An alligator showed up on her front porch. Now, look, here's the thing. When you say, see you later, alligator, that alligator is gonna follow up. Don't say it unless you mean it, guys, okay? Same applies to in a while, crocodile. They'll come back. And finally, here's something we wanted to warn you about. According to new research, the back seat of a rideshare vehicle has over 35,000 times more germs than the average toilet seat. Yeah, I know. They are definitely losing at least half a star. Rideshare seats are dirtier and more dangerous than a toilet seat. Plus, the toilet seat won't spend 20 minutes rambling about his idea to make socks for dogs. It's pretty gross. In fact, the government has now mandated that they change their name from Uber to Uber.